Hi children, today we are going to see about measurement of mass. Heavier object we'll represent as H and the lighter object we'll represent as L. Here pumpkin is heavier, so we represent pumpkin as H, and the hat is lighter, so we represent hat as L. See children, this is a pan balance. This you can see in all the provisional stores to measure the weight of the objects. This pan balance is used to measure the weight of the objects. See here, in this pan balance, one pan has two apples and the other pan has three oranges. Here, the pan which goes down is heavier and the pan which goes up is lighter. The pan which goes down is heavier. So, three oranges are heavier than two apples. So, we represent three oranges as H and two apples as L. See, in this picture, no pan goes up and no pan goes down. Both the pans are at same level. This indicates that the weights in both the pans are equal. That is, one apple weighs as much as two lemons. That is, one apple is equal to two lemon. One apple is equal to two lemon. That is, one apple weighs as much as two lemons. See here children, will one apple always weighs as much as two lemons? That is, always the one apple will be equal to two lemons. What will happen if the size of the apple is big or the size of the lemons are big? In this case, we cannot find the weights of the objects. Similarly, see here, one textbook is equal to 5 stones. That is, here also two pans are at same level. So, one textbook is equal to 5 stones. That is, one textbook weighs as much as 5 stones. But will it be possible in all cases that in every place the size of the stone will be same or the size of the textbook will be same? What will happen if the size of the stone is big? If the size of the book is big, means how will you measure the weight of the object? To avoid this confusion only, we are using the standard units of measurements. For avoiding this confusion only, we are using standard units of measurements. See here children, the lighter objects like pencil, apple, paperclip, coin can be measured using the unit called gram. This can be measured using the unit called gram. Lighter objects can be measured in gram. Gram can be represented as G. See children, only the lighter objects we should measure using gram. It will be represented as G. See here, these are gram stone weights. This you have seen in provisional stores. See, 50 grams, 100 grams, 200 grams, 500 grams. These are the gram stone weights that are used to measure the weight of the object accurately. See, now there is no doubt that one textbook is equal to 250 gram. That is, the book weighs 250 gram. The book weighs 250 gram. It will be same in all places. There will not be any confusion. Always 250 gram remains 250 gram only. There will be no change. Similarly, heavier objects can be measured in kilogram. Kilogram can be represented as kg. See children, only the heavier objects you should measure in the kilogram. Kilogram can be represented as kg. These are the kilogram weight stones. 1 kilogram, 2 kilograms, 5 kilograms. These are the weights used to measure the heavier objects. See here, it is a jackfruit. Jackfruit weighs 2 kilograms. Jackfruit weighs 2 kilograms. See here children, what is this? It is a washing machine. It is a heavier object. So we should measure washing machine in kilogram. The same way, it is a feather. Feather is a lighter object. So we have to measure feather in gram. Children, now it's your activity time. Take two paper cups and thread. Make a pan balance of your own. Take any object and measure the weight of that object. Thank you.